Rwanda is a very special place. Not even 15 years ago, millions of people died in an incredible way. Now this country is trying to come back to life. If they will find a way to do it, I would say that Rwanda could become a paradise. We are on the top of the hill, and one of the thousand hills belongs to the children's Kigarama. Children Village Kigarama started functioning in November 1994, just a couple of months after the genocide and civil war. We're an orphanage and we are taking care of children. Right now we have over 130 kids. There is something that for sure we will never be able to do, and that is to replace the parents. We are trying to come as close as possible to a family atmosphere. I would say that we are moving from darkness into light. I am the director of the Children's Village Kigarama. My work here is to give directions. I am discovering resources and developing them. Rwanda is my home. Very early in the morning, after breakfast, after all the house duties have been finished, the children walk to school. Everyone, without exception, at the Children's Village Kigarama is going to school. The majority of our kids who live right now at the orphanage are attending primary school. We have 6 kids attending university right now. The primary school is between 15 and 20 minutes walk from our campus. A country like Rwanda needs education. They have natural resources, but probably the best resource that they have is the humans. Can you imagine being the mother of 8 babies at the same time? It must be very intensive. Some years ago, we were not able to admit babies. We didn't have the capacity, we didn't have the knowledge. Right now we have 2 mothers and 1 person who is only doing laundry the entire day.
Niyo mbona bari kwiga bakarangiza bagatangira gufata ubuzima bwabo bagashobora kwibeshaho nabo biranshimishije.
Mothers like Christine are taking care of our babies in a very intensive way. The mothers feed the babies. The mothers clean the babies. The mothers protect, take care of the babies. The mothers are constantly around the babies, giving them attention, giving them warmth.
Bigatuma rero ariko wenda tubyuka nka saa kumi n'imwe n'igice.
I can just say thank you to all the mothers at the baby house, especially for Christine, for doing such an extraordinary work. I will not be able to do it. This small baby house is given the possibility to some precious human beings to remain alive. If we will not have it, they will die. We have family units. Every house functions separately and they also do their own cooking. Every family prepares breakfast, prepares lunch, and supper. If you would have been here 2 years ago, I would have shown you the kitchens. There were an open fire in a closed room. I mean, can you imagine the amount of smoke that was produced in a room like that? You would have not been able to stay there longer than 30 seconds. Another huge problem was the incredible amount of energy waste. We have now, thank friends around the world, very special kitchens and very special firewood stoves. The orphanage is developing into a technology demonstration center. The kitchens are a typical example. Those kitchens have increased enormously the life quality of our kids and our staff. The kids are getting enough food, but of course we can still improve it a lot.
My name is Teresa. I'm in the orphanage as a volunteer.
Most of the time I'm working with the kids and babies. I'm also dancing with the girls. It's great that the kids show me all the steps and they are so patient and it's such a great joy to be with them.
We have orphan children here. And they have suffered enough. Whoever is around is amazed. How is possible that orphans can be so happy? Why they dance with so much joy? I think this is something that we Westerns are invited to learn. We have not learned everything.
narinzi ko ndi mugakiza ariko nako nigeze.
There is something going on every evening here at the orphanage. We don't have electricity on the evenings, and the children come together and they sing. They have been singing since years and years.
Nitwa Betty Nyirangeza Hayo, mfite imyaka 16. Impamvu nkunda kuba muri korali ni uko iyo ndi kuririmba hari byinshi nibagirwa, nkagira bimwe binezeza. Indi mpamvu nkunda korali ni uko niho murira na bagenzi banjye dukora umurimo ushimishije, kandi mu kuririmba numva binyuze. Nk'iyo turi guhimba indirimbo tukumva zibaye nziza, biratunezeza twese nka korali.
We have already produced 2 CDs. I hope that one of these days other people around the world will be able to listen to them. They have the potential to become excellent singers and musicians. I envision that the choir will have a concert, and why not one of these days we can go to Kenya? Or maybe go to Europe. I mean, let us dream. Why not? We are not only taking care of our own children, we also would like to have an impact and an influence in the neighboring community. Therefore, we have decided to start a tailoring school. They learn to become tailors. They go through an experience of 2 years long learning how to deal with all what concerning tailoring. And after that, they know how to do it, and they get the possibility to earn their own livelihood by doing that. Right now, none of our kids is attending the tailoring school. They are mainly kids from the neighborhood. We have already the third generations of tailors being graduated here at the Children's Village Camp. There are moments that are gold, are precious, and you take those moments with you for the rest of your life. Simple moments, very little simple moments that are there, yes. This ability to enjoy life, the ability to play with little stones, the ability to make out of garbage a toy, this is a pleasure to see the kids having joy and fun. When we have nice weather, we all go down to the lake that is only 20 minutes down the hill. We have dugout canoes, and the kids got already swimming lessons. That means they are not afraid of getting into the water anymore. If you will join us, you will experience a beautiful water party going on. We can spend hours with the kids just having fun, forgetting all your problems or your sorrows. We do that as much as we can. We are still doing mistakes in places like Africa. We want to help, but we need to know how to help. This first generation of kids, direct victims of the genocide, they got all the help of the world. They have learned to scream for help. Now we have here another generation of children. They are learning that they need to work if they want to achieve something in life. When the orphanage started, there was no water available. the kids were fetching every single drop of water from a well about 300 meters away from here. Friends helped us to install rainwater catchment systems. Now every family unit have a system with a capacity of 10,000 liters. For drinking, we have a water purification system. It's using solar power. It's a combination of three filters. Just to make it completely sure, we let it go through an ultraviolet filter. We can say that we have 99.9999% of pure water. Water is part of a healthy lifestyle. We have 2 hectares of vegetable production for own consumption. We have about 5 to 7 hectares of fruit production. The idea is to dry the fruit, to export it to Europe, to the United States, to Japan. We are using the resource lands to generate income. With this income, the orphanage will be able to supply all the needs by ourselves. What whoever in this place needs to learn is that you are the only one responsible for your own life. Only you. And if you have not learned that, you will miss the point. You see these little kids? They can become lawyers, engineers, architects, medical doctors. There are no limits. Rwanda needs a generation of dreamers. People who are not afraid to dream, who are able to fulfill their own dreams. If we have some of these kids doing that, you will see Rwanda in a different state of development. Here we are, far away in the hills of Rwanda. We are aiming to reach, in a period of 7 years, completely self-sufficiency. There is no orphanage worldwide who has ever achieved that. We are inviting the rest of the world to make a dream become true. The dream of a small, tiny organization finding their own place and task. I thank everyone who has already helped us. Without that help, it would have been impossible. But still, the challenge is big, and whoever would like to get involved, please join us.